what we're doing here.
No, not really.
That's good. I mean, yeah. I think that's a great mindset. I wish more businesses.
Well, the people in coffee are supposed to, we're all supposed to stick together. And that's what some people just don't understand. Like, we stick together as a family. Mm-hmm. It's okay. There's food and water and treats.
I'm Zona, and I'm actually from Jones.
I'm Lindsay Martin from Legacy Brand Photography. I was trying to hear you over the laughing. I'm like,
who's the last person?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
I'll probably need to re-record that. And then hear me one more time and the way that they can get a hold of you guys.
Okay. I'm Jennifer, and I'm the manager at Floyd and Blackie's in Cramerton.
So this is Brutally Honest, and we're actually doing our show at the Cramerton Coffee Shop, which is Floyd and Blackie's, and we're so excited to be able to sit down with the manager and just kind of talk to her and ask her some questions just about you guys' motto, how you run things, like how you stayed open in the middle of COVID, like all of that stuff, because it's really important. And we have taken precautions. We all know that we don't have COVID, so
I'm glad pretty comfortable.
but we are following the guidelines, so that way you know we are being safe. We hope you're being safe. And yeah, so actually, can we have you introduce yourself?
So I am Jennifer. I am the manager of Floyd and Blackie's. So we have two locations. So we have the one here in Cramerton, and we also have the one in McAddenville. That's our bakery. So they make all of, like, our cheesecakes and brownies and cookies and everything else is super, super good.
Right.
Yes.
I've had some.
Yeah.
The first time she brought me, she's like, you have to see the cakes.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I'm like,
they're so good.
You're having me drive 1 hour and 10 minutes to go to a coffee shop to see cakes. And I'm like, oh my gosh, there's like at least 12 things for me to pick from and I can't pick anything.
They're life changing.
Yeah.
Life changing.
So we're very excited to hear about kind of the growth process of Floyd and Blackie's. So how did you guys actually get started? How did you end up here?
So it actually was, the owners, Greg and Kathy, it was like a dream that they had, and they just kind of worked towards it. And it used to be Greg down by the river, renting out kayaks, and then this building was empty, and they were just like, it's a coffee shop. Mm-hmm. And so they just opened it up, and it was really slow at first. And I started about 4 years ago, mm-hmm. and it was still pretty slow whenever I started. And then it just like out of nowhere, just started booming.
Yeah. Well, the crazy thing is you guys can still rent out kayaks in the summer, right? So you still have like all of that. People can reserve stuff.
Oh yeah. And it didn't slow down even with COVID. People, were wanting to go outside more because that's what they were saying, to get outside and do like outdoor things. And I mean, you can socially distance obviously in a kayak because, you have your paddle, so you have to kind of stay a little bit far apart.
That's true. I poke
people with them.
Yeah.
That's also true.
Six feet apart.
No, one of the first times I ever walked out by, because there's picnic tables out there too that people can sit at, and they can like watch people go down the river, which is really fun. I totally walked out there in flip flops, and it was raining, and I'm wearing white pants, and I absolutely slid down the hill.
Oh no.
And I was like, well, this is an interesting experience. So if I have any pictures of that, I'll put it in the video, because it was hilarious. But it was like there was something had in the kayak that looked really cool, and I was like, oh my gosh, I want to see that closer.
Yeah.
I did not see it closer, but it was funny.
Yeah.
You didn't get closer?
I mean, not in a place where I could view anything or any of the bushes. So Floyd and Blackie's opened how long ago?
8 years ago, earlier this month.
Wow,
yeah, we just had our birthday. Yeah.
And McAddenville is where they do Christmas Town.
Right.
So how does that affect you guys' bakery?
So we were a little concerned that it wasn't going to be, because they weren't lighting up the lake this year. We were concerned that it wasn't going to be as busy as it usually is. But surprisingly, they've just been they've been slammed. So we're very grateful for that.
Yeah, it's beautiful. If you haven't been to Christmas Town, you should definitely go. And can we go into the bakery?
Yeah, they just remodeled.
Did you need me for this?
No,
don't
you? It's okay.
I'm so sorry. we're gonna leave that in the video. Just Patrick off screen with like
It's okay. It's fine.
It's too late for you to save yourself.
Yeah. No, they just remodeled, so they are now technically two buildings, and they just knocked the wall out. And
but we were really wanting to talk to you guys out because you really managed to make it through COVID. I mean, not unscathed. Every business was affected, but you kept your doors open. You didn't have to fire everyone.
No,
that's a big deal.
We actually didn't fire anybody.
Awesome.
So we're very, very proud about that.
Yeah, that's, I mean, especially because I mean, this is a smaller town.
Yeah,
people need work.
That they do. We were a little concerned, but then, like, you know, whenever they were announcing that they were gonna, you know, everything had to be like takeout, and we were trying to figure out how exactly we were gonna make that work. But we ended up getting, it was Clusive, now it's Odeco. So it's like an online ordering app, and you just have an app on your phone, put everything in, it has our full menu and breakfast and ice cream and desserts and everything's all in there. So fortunately that people caught on to that pretty quickly.
Right. Well, and with so many restaurants closed, I'm sure that helped too.
Yeah.
Like especially having like your breakfast stuff and everything on there. And who doesn't still need coffee?
I don't know. I do every day.
Yeah, kind of that way.
We're
too.
Still going until like at least 8 at night. I think you stop around 8.
Right.
And I'm like, you're such a slacker.
Keep going.
It has only been in the last like 6 months or so that I've even started drinking decaf, and
yeah.
I mean, that's what I drink after 8 o'clock. So, it's my weird coffee habits, don't mind me. But yeah, so I was just wondering, like, how did you guys overcome, like, how did you help deal with, you know, employees and what they were facing and making sure they were protected and stuff like that too?
Well, we did, you know, start doing the masks and gloves and, you know, making sure that we have everything that we need to sanitize everything, and going through sanitizing, we were doing it about every like 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Like whether somebody was in here or not, like just to make sure that everything was, you know, clean for whenever people came in, and like making, when I say wiping down everything, we were, I mean, we still are obviously. I mean, we did before too, but like we took like extra precaution to make sure every single thing that people were touching was wiped down.
That's really cool. Now, with some of the coffee, I was told that you guys do something a little bit different, where you use a little bit better coffee.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Our coffee is 100% organic. It's, you know, nothing's added to it, nothing taken away from it, and it is so good.
That's awesome.
So good.
Which is pretty unique, honestly,
yeah.
Is actually having organic coffee that you aren't being, like, upcharged for, where they're like, oh,
right.
This is our regular coffee, but
yeah,
we have organic. But you guys actually use that in all your drinks and everything?
Yes, we do. And we have a couple different espresso blends that we use, so we have one that we make ourselves here.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like our blend of beans. And then we have another one that we get from a place in Shelby.
Very cool. Which is still pretty close.
It's still close. Yeah, it's about a 30, 35 minute drive.
Awesome. So you guys are supporting other local businesses?
Oh, yes. Yeah, we always support local.
That's really
shop
great.
Local.
So I had seen something where you guys have like helped other businesses kind of get started.
Yeah, there's the Virgin Bean, for example, in
mm-hmm.
South Carolina. They are some of our pretty good friends, and so Greg kind of helped to guide them in the right direction that they needed to go in order. You know, they roasted their beans before, but now he just kind of helped to guide them in the direction that they needed to open up their own shop,
awesome.
Which is a little bit different.
I like that. Coffee family.
It's a family, yeah.
It's very like coffee family.
We do. So yeah, we just wanted to kind of touch base. I know you had some other questions. It was kind of more,
yeah, pointed with my question.
Yeah, yes.
Most of them already covered. I'm trying to think of what else I even had left. How did the name originate, Floyd and Blackie's?
That is actually Greg and Kathy's grandparents. So they were friends whenever they were younger. I know, it's so sweet. And it's such like a small town kind of thing, and I love it. Like, so, Blackie is Greg's grandfather, and Floyd is Kathy's grandfather.
Wow.
That's neat.
That is really cool. I was wondering about that.
Yeah.
I was like, wait a minute.
Yep, it's definitely a family-owned business, for sure.
Wow. So that's really cool. So then, as far as, like, giving back to the community, obviously you help build
yeah.
other businesses up and really encourage growth. Yes. Just with everybody, it feels like. I mean, it definitely is homey here. Like,
yeah.
People are always friendly when you come in and everything like that. Is there anything else that you guys see kind of on the horizon? You already have the bakery in McAddenville, but I'm assuming it's probably not going to stop there.
You'll just have to see about that one.
She's spoiler.
I know, right?
You'll just have to see.
So we're so excited to be able to sit here and to really enjoy the coffee shop here in Cramerton, and for you guys to be able to come and enjoy it too. So if you guys are here, make sure you stop in, make sure you let them know that Brutally Honest sent you, and drop in the comments what your favorite drink was when you came here and you tried.
For sure.
Awesome.
Okay.
What is your favorite drink here?
Ooh, okay, so I love just brewed coffee. Mm-hmm. I'm a huge fan of brewed coffee. I'll put like a little bit of honey in the bottom and then some almond milk.
And that's the way you go.
It is.
Yeah.
She normally does almond milk.
Super good.
Sometimes
it's my favorite. But if I'm doing like a latte, then I like our cinnamon roll latte.
But they have toasted marshmallow, which everyone also doesn't always carry. Some people have it and some don't. Mm-hmm. So today I've got lavender and toasted marshmallow.
You like it?
Of course.
I realized that we did the same thing here that we did in the last one, is that this is my drink and this is your drink.
I don't think so.
Yeah, because this is the girl stout with the extra shot, and that's definitely lavender. So the last coffee shop we went to, we did the same thing.
Yeah.
And like when they handed us the drinks,
handed it to me and told me what it was. So I'm like, okay. I don't know, but it's good. This one does taste different than that one.
Or flour. Guys, she literally drank like so much of this. It's okay. She's gonna be super caffeinated.
You were talking, and I'm like, I've got nothing else to do except go like this. Ping pong. Ping pong. All right, drink it.
Yeah. Anyways. But interesting. Superman affogato. I've never tried that.
I haven't either.
Dare.
Yeah.
Try that one.
Tell us how magical the pies are.
The pies and cakes are magical. You should come eat all of them. Surely, if you're supporting a local business, the calories negate themselves. Don't you think?
Sure.
One thing, we don't like to, put ourselves up on a pedestal, but we're also pretty good at helping people find their dogs.
Nice.
So, yeah, there's everybody kind of lives really close together, and people's dogs get out, and for some reason they always come here, every single time. They always come here.
Maybe it's the lake view.
Yeah,
the dogs like
usually we're like always just within the same day, like they're back home with the owner, so we're pretty proud of that one.
That's really great.
Yeah.